The experiment is LCR resonance circuit. Resonance is a phenomenon in which natural frequency of the LCR system matches with the applied frequency from the oscillator. At XL is equal to XC, natural frequency of the LCR system match with the applied frequency, then the system is said to be a resonance and the frequency is known as resonance frequency. Quality factor is defined as the ratio of voltage across the inductor to the voltage across the capacitor. There are two types of resonance circuit. First one is the LCR series resonance circuit, is also known as frequency acceptor circuit because it accepts the frequency at which circuit resonance. And second one is the LCR parallel resonance circuit, is also known as rejector circuit because it rejects the frequency at which circuit resonance and attains a minimum current. And in the series resonance circuit, current attains a maximum value. The application of LCR resonance circuits are used as filter circuits such as FM radios with analog tuners and also used as communication circuits. Let us come to the aim of the experiment. The aim of this experiment is to study the frequency response of LCR series and parallel resonance circuit and also determine the self-inductance and quality factor of the given self-inductor. And operators required for that experiment are experimental setup consists of audio frequency oscillator and a circuit board having an inductor, capacitor, resistor and connecting wires. This is the audio frequency oscillator. In that audio frequency oscillator, it consists of DC, voltage control knob, amplitude and frequency terminal. These are the frequency range terminals. And this is the digital circuit board. In this digital circuit board, milliammeter is there. It is a current measuring device. For that current measuring device, terminals are here. And this circuit board also consists of inductor. In that inductor, we are going to use L1 inductor only. For that L1 inductor, terminals are here. And these are the three resistors. In these three resistors, we are going to use a 1 kilo ohm resistor. For that resistor, terminals are here. And these are the three capacitors. In these three capacitors, we are going to use 0.01 microfarad capacitor. For that device, terminals are here. This solid black line indicates inbuilt connection. There is an inbuilt connection from one terminal to the another terminal. This dotted line indicates no inbuilt connection from one terminal to the another terminal. We have to connect external connecting wires by using external connecting wires. The EMF induced in an inductor is known as inductance, measured with the unit Henry. The property of resistor flow of charges is known as resistance, measured with the unit Ohm. And ability of storing charges in an capacitor, call it as capacitance, measured with the unit Farad. Come to the circuit connection. Here, this is the series resonance circuit. AC source is connected to the milliammeter. Milliammeter another end is connected to the inductor. Inductor another end is connected to the capacitor. Capacitor another end is connected to the resistor. Resistor another end is connected to the source, AC source. This is the, and from the AC source is connected to input circuit. Next we have to connect positive of ammeter to the M terminal and negative of ammeter to the N terminal. Positive milliammeter to the N terminal, negative milliammeter to the N terminal, and inductor first end to the A terminal and inductor another end to the B terminal, and resistor first end to the F terminal, resistor second end to the G terminal, capacitor first end to the D terminal, capacitor another end to the E terminal. This is the LCR series circuit. then switch on the board and also AC audio frequency oscillator. By using this frequency knob, here voltage and amplitude are kept constant. By using this frequency knob, we have to vary the frequency from 1 kHz to the 10 kHz, then note down the corresponding current in the digital circuit board. This is 1 kilohertz. 1 kilohertz current is around 0.75. Write down 0.75 milliamps. Write down here 0.75 milliamps. Then again we have to vary the frequency to 1.5 kilohertz. This is 1.5 kilohertz. For 1.5 kilohertz, current varies to 1.16. Note down here. Then again we have to vary the frequency from 1.5, 2, 2.5, 3, 3.5, like that we have to vary the frequency. Then note down the corresponding current. We are already taking the reading from 1 kHz to the 10 kHz in the step of 0.5. We getting like this. Once you getting the reading, after we have to plot the graph frequency versus current. We have to set the scale for x axis 1 cm is equal to 1 kHz and for y axis 1 cm is equal to 1 milliamps. Then for the first trial, for one frequency we have to take along x axis and current we have to take along y axis. For 1 kHz frequency, corresponding current that is 0.7, that will comes here. And for 1.5, this will comes here. For 1.5, this is 1.19. This will comes here. Then again we have to plot the graph for all the readings from 1 kHz to the 10 kHz. Then we getting curve like this. This is the LCR series resonance curve. And here current attains a maximum value. From that maximum attaining current, draw a perpendicular line to the x-axis that gives resonance frequency. Once you getting resonance frequency, substitute that to the formula. We have the formula for calculating self-inductance, that is L is equal to 1 by 4 pi square F naught square into C. Here F naught, that will be, that is in the graph, 5 kilohertz. For kilo we have to substitute 10^+3. And C, capacitance of capacitor, that is 0.01 microfarad. Substitute here, we getting self-inductance 0.1 Henry. After getting the self-inductance, we have to substitute that self-inductance to the quality factor formula. And here R is the resistance of the inductance coil, that is 4.5 ohm. Substitute here. This is the quality factor formula. Q is equal to 2 pi F naught L divided by R, that gives 705. It has unitless quantity. It has no unit. Unitless quantity because quality factor is defined as the ratio of voltage across the inductor to the voltage across the capacitor. But to do parallel resonance circuit. Source, AC oscillator source is connected to milliamps. Milliammeter another end is connected to inductor. Inductor another terminal is connected to resistor. Resistor another terminal is connected to capacitor. Capacitor another terminal is connected to milliammeter. And source another terminal is connected to resistor. This is the parallel resonance circuit. Like that we have to do that in the circuit board. This is the series connection. From that series connection, we have to remove the capacitor terminals only. Then you have to short the series connection of capacitor. Like that, we have to short the series connection of capacitor. Then one end of the capacitor is connected to J and another end of the capacitor is connected to K. Then similarly, we have to do the, you have to vary the frequency from 1 kHz to the 10 kHz. From one, for 1 kHz frequency, that will comes in the order of 8.92. write down the reading 8.191. Then again we have to vary the frequency for 0.5. Again we have to vary the frequency to 1.5 kilohertz. For 1.5 kilohertz current it will comes in 7.23. similarly we have to vary the frequency from again we have to vary the frequency 2 kilohertz, 2.5 kilohertz, like that we have to vary the frequency up to the 10 kilohertz. Then note down the corresponding current here. Already we have to taken a reading from 1 kilohertz to the 10 kilohertz, we getting like this. Then after getting the reading, we have to plot the frequency versus current. For parallel resonance curve, also we have to set the scale. For x axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 kilohertz, and for y axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 milliamps. Like that, we have to adjust the scale for both x axis and y axis. And here also we have to take frequency along x axis and current along y axis. For first trial, for 1 kilohertz current it will comes in 8.95 coming here, and for 1.5 kilohertz current that is 7.26 comes here. Then similarly we have to plot the graph for another trials. Then we getting curve like this. This is the LCR parallel resonance curve. And here in the LCR parallel resonance curve, current attains a minimum value. From that attaining minimum value, draw a perpendicular line to the x axis that gives resonance frequency. Here for parallel resonance curve also we getting resonance frequency 5 kilohertz. That is same, because resonance frequency can change by changing inductance and capacitance. It cannot be changes by changing the resistance. Then after getting the resonance frequency, similarly we have to substitute the resonance frequency to the formula, we getting self inductance. And here self inductance and quality factor also getting same. Also getting same, that is 0.10 Henry and 705 quality factor. Substitute that in the result column. For both and series and parallel resonance, result are same. Resonance frequency 5 kHz, self inductance 0.1 Henry and quality factor 705.